Domino's is world famous for its pizza, but according to some employees, there's one thing you should never order from the chain's menu: sandwiches. Wait, Domino's has sandwiches?
What the f*** does that have to do with pizza?
Actually, the fact that most people don't know Domino's even has sandwiches is one big reason you should never order them. As according to one Reddit user claiming to be a Domino's employee, the ingredients often go bad before they have a chance to be used. At Domino's, don't order the Philly steak or American cheese. It's only used on the sandwiches and one specialty pizza, so it usually goes bad. Usually, of course, the ingredients are thrown out once they have gone bad, but do you really want to risk getting food that's somewhere in the process of going bad? There's no one in the world that wants to eat steak and cheese that's gone past their prime, after all. Except maybe Oscar the Grouch.
I love it because it's trash!
Additionally, there are a lot of people on Reddit who are of the opinion that Domino's subs just aren't worth it even when the ingredients are fresh. Why? According to one Reddit economics expert, it comes down to a simple cost analysis. They are priced too high to be worth it to me. You could get a medium pizza instead and have way more food. A look at their app says there is some truth to this argument. Prices vary by location, of course, but their sandwiches tend to ring in at about $7.50. Their medium pizzas usually cost around $11, but Domino's often has promotions that give customers a medium pizza with multiple toppings for anywhere from $7 to $10. Sure, the pizza still costs a little more, but it's also bigger, which gives you the benefit of potentially having leftovers as well. And leftover pizza is great, especially compared to leftover sandwiches, which is something nobody wants. Like the president says, when you're hungry, you want pizza.
Jesus Christ, I'm hungry!
Plus, some Reddit taste experts believe the Domino's sandwich is also subpar for the palate, not just the wallet. Sandwiches there remind me of something you'd get out of a vending machine. Open plastic packaging and microwave thusly. Others agreed, with another Reddit food critic saying, their sandwiches taste really cheap, like it's all made of fake cheese and meat. And then another Reddit culinary expert opined that the bread is covered in some greasy oil butter stuff. There's a reason for that, though. Eat This Not That took a closer look at Domino's sandwiches and found they can, at best, only loosely be described as sandwiches. Why? Because they're more accurately described as pizza toppings piled on strange bread.
The Italian was Domino's because it tastes like a pizza sandwich.
That greasy oil butter stuff coating the bread that Redditors found super disgusting is actually a combination of soybean oil and salt, which is just weird. Who wants slimy bread? Even worse than the texture is what it does to the nutritional numbers. Every one of those sandwiches comes loaded with a huge amount of sodium, with each sandwich containing close to the American Heart Association's whole daily recommendation for sodium intake. You're also looking at eating your daily limits when it comes to fat with most of these sandwiches. The healthiest option is the Mediterranean veggie, and it's really only healthy if you cut the 8-inch sub in half and save some for later, or share with a friend. It might be a different story if Domino's was the only chain in the sandwich game, but they're definitely not. There are so many other chains that are doing sandwiches, and doing them so much better, that there's really no reason to order a sub from Domino's if that's what you're really craving. Go somewhere that specializes in fresh ingredients and getting their subs right, and you'll dodge the regret that comes with ordering one from Domino's. That's not to say that Domino's didn't try. According to Ad Age, Domino's made a huge push with their sandwiches back around 2008, and when they debuted this particular addition to their menu, they were trying to become a serious player in the sandwich game.
Are you ready to turn to one of the nation's major pizza chains to order subs?
Here we go. Domino's is making a big bet that you are.
But in order to do that, they seemed to feel they needed to come up with something that no one else was doing. And while they did, they also inadvertently proved that just because something is different doesn't mean it's better.